Welcome back to the 2022 PA American Legion State Tournament. We are back for game number 6 between Blackhawk out of Region 6 and Wilcox out of Region 8.
Both teams having a rough outing yesterday, but looking to get back on track here today.
Earlier today, Norchester defeated Greater Pittston in the 10-15 game, 6-2, so Greater Pittston is eliminated and Norchester has moved on. The winner of this game will stay alive another day and the loser will be eliminated and have to head home. Leading off for Wilcox is Dom Allegretto, followed by Aiden Zimmerman, Cameron Marciniak, Caden Dennis, Luke Zimmerman, Ethan Wells, Colin Porter, Dawn Stolle, and Caden Smiley. Pitching for Blackhawk is Alex Tomsick. The count is 0-1. Fouls that one off there. Fouls that one off way out into the stands. Count is 0-2 on the batter. Dom Allegretto.
Cox had a looking to put some more points on the board today.
Hits that one right back at the pitcher. Pitcher takes his time, goes over there, tosses it to the first baseman, makes the play, gets the first out of the game. So to go around for the defense for Blackhawk, we will have pitcher Alex Tomsick, catcher Jared Malagese, first baseman Josh Rudd, second baseman Antonio Borello, third baseman Zane Priestis-Kish, shortstop Ryan Jones, left fielder Louis Sebastian, center fielder Anthony Malagese, and right fielder Owen Keister. That one's in there for a strike. The count is 1-1, and there is one away in game number 6 of the American Legion State Tournament. Throws that one in there for a strike.
Interesting little fact about Aiden Zimmerman, looking through our notes, his favorite food is cereal. Let's see if that'll help him at bat.
Gets him there, swinging. Two away in the top of the first. Now coming up to bat, number 11, Cameron Marciniak.
Center fielder, number 11, Cam Marciniak.
That one just misses for a ball. Blows that one past him for strike number 2. Or strike number 1. Excuse me. Misses there low for a ball. Count now moves to 2-1. That one is high for ball number 2. To get here, Blackhawk defeated Uniontown 10-4 in Region 6, and Wilcox defeated Brockway 5-0 in Region 8. Count is now full at 3-2, and there are two away in the top of the first. Fouls that one back, out of play. delivers. And that one is
what a hit.
Lined out to the center fielder. Makes the play right to him, and that is out number three. To the bottom of the first we go. Now leading off for Blackhawk and the second baseman, Antonio Borrello. That one is in there, low inside corner for a strike. That one misses low for a ball. Count is now 1-1 in the bottom of the first. Score still 0-0. Blackhawk has a current record of 19-3, and Wilcox has a current record of 16-2 coming into this one. This is a loser's bracket matchup, and the winner will move on to game 9 that will be played at 12:40 tomorrow. That one is popped high into the air. Second baseman gets under it, and he makes the easy catch for one away.
Yeah, nothing's coming up. Yep.
Now batting, shortstop number 21, Ryan Jones. That's an off-speed pitch in there for strike number one. Misses there for a ball. Pitching for Wilcox is number six, Colin Porter. Misses high again there. Count is now 2-1. Catching is Ethan Wells. At first base is Dom Allegretto. Second base is Caden Dennis. Shortstop, Dalton Stolle. Third baseman is Aiden Zimmerman. Left fielder, Luke Zimmerman. Center fielder, Cameron Marciniak. And right fielder, Caden Smiley.
With a ball right there.
Count is now 2-2, and there is one out. Hits that ball, hopping into the air right to the second baseman, collects himself, throws over to first. For out number two. Now batting for Blackhawk, number 9, Anthony Malagish. That's in there for ball one. And now there will be a meeting at the mound between the pitcher and the catcher, Colin Porter and Ethan Wells. That one's high, missing for a ball. Throws that one in there for strike number one. Count is now 2-1, and they're two away in the bottom of the first. Off-speed pitch in there for strike number two, hitting the corner there. Just misses there. Count is now full. Malagish has had 34 bats coming into this tournament, 8 hits throughout the season, and there are 21 games before getting here. And he got hit there, so that will put a runner on.
Finally able to get on base
for Blackhawk. The four hitter will now come up to bat. The catcher, Jared Malagish, brother of Anthony Malagish. Hits that one high into the air, into right center field. Center fielder gets under that and easily makes the catch.
Defensive and game so far.
I guess the umpires were discussing there that the pitcher balked actually, so before the pitch, so the runner advances to second and Malagish is still up to bat, as his brother is on second base in scoring position, waiting for him to potentially drive him in with two outs here. He misses there high with the off speed, and there are two outs in the bottom of the first. Hits that at the third baseman charging in. Turns, and there is now a rundown going on. Flips it to the second baseman, tags him on the head, and he is out. That is three outs. So that is it for the first inning. We will be back for more in the top of the second. throws that one low for another ball, and the count is full. He did not go. Another off-speed pitch in there for a strike. Count is now 1-2. Two away in the bottom of the second. That one is outside for a ball. Besides baseball, Zane played wrestling in high school. Or was a wrestler in high school. That one is fouled off.
Also a supporter of Pittsburgh sports, his favorite teams are the Pirates, and it also supports the Steelers as well.
His favorite baseball player is Mike Trout. That one misses low there for a ball. Count is now 3-2. And that one is another strike in there for strike number 3 as he retires the side. And we are moving into the top of the 3rd inning. We will be right back.
His kids had won it, Bobby Thompson had done it, and Yogi read the comics all the while. Rock and roll was being born, marijuana we would scorn, so down on the corner the national pastime went on trial. We're talking baseball, Klazuski Campanella, talking baseball, the man and Bobby fella, the scooter, the barber and the nuke. They knew them all from Boston to Dubuque, especially Willie, Mickey, and the Duke. Well, Casey was winning, Hank Aaron was beginning, one Robbie going out, one coming in. Kiner and Midget Goodell, the Thumper and Mel Parnell, and Ike was the only one winning down in Washington. I'm talking baseball, Klazuski, Campanella, Buke, especially Willie, Mickey, and the Duke.
Now batting the pitcher number 6, Colin Porter. That is low for a ball. Count is 1-1 here in the top of the 3rd inning.
Another supporter of Pittsburgh, as he is a fan of the Pirates. His favorite player is Starling Marte.
Hits that one foul down the first baseline. Besides baseball, Colin was also a wrestler, and he enjoys golfing. Now batting number 22, Dalton Staley, the 3rd baseman.
Zero, zero. What do you mean, what's
The score is 0-0 right now. We are in the top of the third inning, and there is a ball and no strikes on the hitter. That one is in there for strike number one. The count is now 1-1, and there is one away in the top of the third.
Both pitchers looking great so far to start off the game.
Throws another one in there that the hitter takes for strike number two. One and two on the batter now. Off-speed pitch, he grounds that one to the pitcher. Pitcher spins, throws, and the first baseman cannot pick that one up. And the hitter was going to make his way to second, but decides to stay at first base. And I would say that is a hit because he made it there before the throw was even there. Now batting the nine hitter, number 28, Caden Smiley. That one is thrown high up there for ball number one. Put it on the bottom left. It's supposed to be. It's because you gotta hit the check on it, bro. Oh my gosh. It's because you didn't hit the check on it. But. Okay, yeah, the scoreboard is up there now. Count is 1-2 on the batter. Move it. Yeah, move it down. There we go. I'll try that. That's behind. Stop moving it up there, dude. Count is 2-2. The runner advanced from first to second base now. Caden Smiley is still batting. The count 2-2. There is one away here in the bottom of the third, or top of the third. Yeah. It's audio until the visual is good. Then don't worry about it. I'll tell you when it moves. I'm watching it too. That still says team one and team two, Noah. You gotta
change that.
Okay. Hits that one. The shortstop charges in, fires it over to first, makes a play. Runner running to third, and the tag is not in time as the runner is safe at third base. There are two away now in the top of the third inning.
Okay, nothing is. The kid went over third. Nothing has changed with that screen, with this scoreboard. Nothing. Still in the same spot. Still says team one and team two.
They are adjusted on that.
I just watched.
They're changed on mine.
Okay, now Blackhawk came up. But team two still says team two.
They should adjust.
That one is hit right at the first baseman. The first baseman dives, picks it up, flips it to the pitcher, and that is not in time as the runner for Wilcox scores, and the score is now 1-0.
It would be better if it was off altogether than in the middle of the screen, so get it the hell out.
Yeah, I'll just take it off.
Yeah, take this.
Yeah.
Get it out. Till you
I just turned it off.
Now batting number 27, Aiden Zimmerman. That ball is driven into right center field. The center fielder runs in and makes the catch. All right, now hand it.
That barrel's in that.
Leading off, number 23, the right fielder for Wilcox, or for Blackhawk, Owen Keister. Score is 1-0. Wilcox scored in the top of the third. Hits that one up to the second baseman. Second baseman makes the dive and throws it over, and it is not in time. And there was interference called on that play, so the runner will advance from first to second.
Blackhawk looking to get on the scoreboard for the first time today. Going to get a run right here.
Number 15, the pitcher, Alex Tomczyk, up to bat. Only three hits so far in this one. Wilcox has two. Flashes the bunt there. Wilcox has two, and Blackhawk has one hit. Runner in scoring position on second base. The count 1-1 on the pitcher, Alex Tomczyk. Bunts there, but it is called foul ball because the batter was still in the box. Count now 1-2 on the hitter. little pitcher-on-pitcher action here between Colin Porter and Alex Tomczyk. Misses there outside for a ball. Fouls that one back. Tomczyk is a fan of the Buffalo Bills and plans on attending Washington and Jefferson College to play baseball. One of his rituals while pitching is he can't let the coach fix the mound before he pitches. That one is in there for strike number three. As he strikes him out, there is now one away. Now batting number two, Antonio Borrello, the second baseman. That one is thrown high in there for a ball. Fouls that one back out of play.
Very vocal dugout on Blackhawks' side.
One and one on the hitter, one away in the bottom of the third. He throws the off-speed pitch in there for strike number two. Checks the runner at second. Looks and fires home for strike number three. Caught him looking for out number two. Now batting the number two hitter in this lineup, number 21, Ryan Jones, the shortstop. Misses there outside for a ball. Ryan Jones is a fan of the Tampa Bay Rays, and his sports other than baseball are basketball. He enjoys fishing, is a fan of the Pittsburgh Steelers, and his favorite baseball player is Mike Trout. One and one now on the batter. Brief meeting will be held here on the mound. There's an off-speed pitch and it's fouled back out of play. Pitcher checks the runner, fires home, and that one is also fouled out of play. The batter, Ryan Jones, hanging in there. Checks the runner, fires, misses there. Count now even at two. And there are two away in the bottom of the third. The runner in scoring position on second base. fouls another one off, really hanging in there.
Really making this pitcher work here. Again, a very, very, very vocal dugout coming from Blackhawk.
Throws that one just outside for ball three. The count is now full at 3-2.
Stands are coming alive now.
Batter's gonna have to swing at anything close here. That one is high for ball four. And now there are runners on first and second base as the three hitter, number nine, Anthony Malagis, comes up to bat.
For all that, Jones finally takes his base.
Pitcher checks the runner. Throws that one past him. 0-1. And it is a great day for baseball out here at Boyertown Bear Stadium.
Great game so far. A great 2 days.
And that is fouled back out of play. Pitcher's ahead on the batter, 0-2. Fires outside and low in the dirt for ball one.
Just need one more. Hoping to take his team to the fourth inning.
Throws another off-speed pitch in there. Spoils that one to hang in there. There's a fastball in there. That one is hit to the right of the second baseman. He flips it to get the force out at second to end the bottom of the third. And now we will move on to the fourth inning. We will be right back. Marciniak leading off for Wilcox. or yeah, top of the fourth. Misses there low for ball number one. Only three hits so far in this one. Wilcox has two of them as they lead 1-0. That one is hit high into the air. Center fielder gets under it, runs in on it, and makes the play. Easy can of corn for him out there. One down. Now batting the cleanup hitter, number 12, Caden Dennis. Off-speed pitch missed low there for ball one.
Aside from baseball, Caden also participates in football and wrestling.
Fouls that one out of play. Caden Dennis is a fan of the Pittsburgh Pirates and the LA Rams. His favorite food is pizza. He enjoys fishing and lifting. That one is thrown high for ball two. Count now 2-1 on the batter. One away here in the top of the fourth. That one called strike number two, count even at two.
Once again, both pitchers are looking really solid today. Not a whole lot of runs so far, at least.
Runs or hits.
Yeah.
Misses high there, the off-speed pitch. Count is now full. Fires for the 3-2 pitch, a called strike three on the batter for out number two. Great pitching here on both sides today. And only one error so far in the game, so great defense in general.
Wilcox in a very similar situation they were in yesterday.
One is high in there for a ball. Number one, Luke Zimmerman, the left fielder, now batting. Throws a fastball in there for a strike. Count is 1-1. Off-speed pitch in there, called for a strike. I'd say both these pitchers love to go to their off-speed pitch.
Absolutely.
A lot, and
absolutely.
It's working great for him today. He throws that fastball in there. I think the batter is looking for another off-speed pitch there, and he
it'll be a quick inning,
throws
say,
a heater in there right past him. And now to the bottom of the fourth we go.
Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
Cleanup hitter number four, Jared Malagish, the catcher, now batting for Blackhawk.
His favorite player is Juan Soto. Sure looked great at the home run derby last week. Or excuse me, earlier in the week. My bad.
Throws an off-speed pitch there outside. Count now moves to 1-1. There's a fastball, misses low there for ball number two. Misses low again, right in the same spot as last time, 3-1. And that one is called on the outside corner. Count is now full at 3-2.
Another full count.
Say the pitchers have really had to work today to get the batters out.
Got them that time though.
Swings at the high pitch for strike number three, and there is one away.
Gotta give a lot of credit to pitcher Colin Porter for hanging in there as well as he has, for sure. You know, these batters have been testing him, but he's always got an answer.
Throws that one past him inside corner for strike number one. Misses there. 1-1 now on the batter. Number five, Josh Reed, the first baseman batting. Swings and misses there. 1-2 on the batter. One away in the bottom of the fourth.
Josh Reed looking to play for Westminster College in the foreseeable future.
And he throws that one past him and strikes him out.
Yeah, we got first base. That damn red dot's in the way. That's why I can't
okay.
see it.
Left fielder number 11, Louis Sebastian,
the left fielder number 11, batting. That one misses high there for ball number one.
Future Nittany Lion looking to give some insurance to his team. He's got a 1-0 count.
There's that one past them. Hits that one, shortstop charging, fires, makes the play easily, and Wilcox gets out of that one in the bottom of the fourth. We are now headed to the top of the fifth inning. Blackhawk still is down 1-0, looking to score some runs here in these last two innings.
We'll be right back.
Top of the fifth inning, number six hitter, Ethan Wells, number 24. Throws that one past him for strike number one. Misses there low for a ball.
Ethan Wells looking to attend University of Pitt Johnstown. Also important to note that his socks have to be on the right feet.
That's one of his rituals.
Yes, sir. He's got a 3-0 count.
No, it's 2-1.
Two and one. There we go. My mistake.
Throws that one past him. The count is now 2-2. Throws an off-speed pitch. Misses there. Barely misses the strike zone. Count is full. A lot of full counts in this one, really making the pitchers work. Hitters have done a great job of hanging in there, fouling off pitches, and he has walked on that one. Now batting number six, Colin Porter, the pitcher.
Got another pitcher on pitcher matchup.
Shows the bunt, and he fouls it off, so the runner will have to go back to first base. Very defensive game in this one, but Wilcox trying to add more runs to extend their lead. Goes for the pickoff move, not in time. Dives back in safely into first base. Goes again for the pickoff move. Really trying to get that out over there at first base. It's already got two guys earlier today with that pickoff move. Shows the bunt. Bunts it down right back to the pitcher. Pitcher fields it, spins, and fires the first for out number one. The runner advances to second and is now in scoring position. Now batting number 22, Dalton Stolle. Stolle is also a fan of the Pirates and the Steelers, and he enjoys golfing and listening to music. His favorite food is cereal.
Another wrestler on the team, I see, also likes to participate.
Throws that one high for ball two. Checks the runner at second. Winds up, fires home. And that is called strike one. Count is now 2-1. There is one away in the bottom of the fifth. Or top of the fifth. Fouls that one back. Count now even at two. Misses low there with the off-speed pitch. Good block by the catcher. Way to stay in front of it and keep the runner from advancing from second to third.
Tomczyk really paying attention to both bases.
Misses low there for a ball, and the runner will be walked, so there is now a runner on first and second base, and it looks like number 28, Caden Smiley, is now coming up to bat. With two runners on, looking to drive in some more. Shows the bunt, fouls that back, and that is out of play. This Wilcox team has the smallest roster in the tournament with only 14 kids. And that one is driven into deep left center field, and the left fielder gets under it to make the catch for out number two.
Wondering if we'll see any home runs here in this game.
So far, there has only been one home run all tournament.
So that came in the game yesterday between Paxton and Norchester.
Yes.
If I'm not mistaken.
Down the left field line, it is 320. Down center field, 380. And right field is also 320. So it's definitely pretty difficult to hit a home run out of here, especially with these wood bats here that the American Legion uses over metal. Double zero, top of the lineup, Dom Allegretto is now up. Pitcher checked the runner at first base, tried to go for another pickoff move. Really worried about these runners on base.
Interesting baseball number, double zero. It's a first for me.
That is high for a ball, count us now. 2-0. There's that one high. Swings, that's into right field. The right fielder is getting under that, and he does to make the play. That is out number three, as we will head to the bottom of the fifth. The score is still Wilcox 1-0, only three hits in this one.
clock in the bottom of the fifth inning. Third baseman number 25, Zane Priestess-Kiss.
Third baseman, the number 7 hitter, Zane Priestess-Kiss, up to bat for Blackhawk. That is in there, inside corner for strike number 1. Blackhawk looking to get on the board here, potentially tie this one up or take the lead.
So far, lots of wrestlers on this Blackhawk team. Executive informed me that Pittsburgh is a very huge wrestling area.
That one is low, missing for a ball. Count is 1-2 on the batter. Zane Priestess-Kiss. Fouls that one off to hang in there. Keep that bat alive. That one is lined up the middle to give Blackhawk a spark of life there with that hit.
Exactly what Blackhawk needed right there. Needed a solid hit.
That is Blackhawk's second hit of the game now.
See if they can capitalize off that. Get some momentum going. Excuse me.
Now batting number 23, Owen Keister. The right fielder shows the bunt, bunts it down right at the pitcher. Pitcher throws it to first, high throw, but he makes the tag. First baseman makes the tag, and he is out at first base. But the runner advances to second, now in scoring position. Now batting number 15, the 9 hitter, Alex Tomczyk, the pitcher. Top of the order, due up.
Tomczyk's been pitching well today so far. See if he can carry that momentum on to the on to.
Drills that one.
Just do that.
That one is in right field. He makes a catch and he throws it to second, but that is not in time to try and get the double play. Two away now in the bottom of the fifth inning. It's not our audio, because you can't mix it. It's the way the YOLO works. Now batting number 2, Antonio Borrello, the leadoff hitter, and second baseman. That one is in there for strike 1. Borrello trying to drive in a run here for his team. He hits that one down the first baseline. That is a foul ball. Borrello has 15 RBIs this season. His batting average is .241 coming into this tournament. That one is fouled out of play on the third base side. Pitcher now way ahead of the batter, 0-2. There are 2 outs in the bottom of the fifth as Wilcox still leads this one 1-0. Very defensive game throughout.
Very, very, very defensive for sure.
That one is hit. The first baseman goes to backhanded, but he cannot make the play there. That'll be an error on the first baseman. The runner is headed home. He misses him on the tag, and he is safe at home. And Blackhawk is now on the board.
Here we go.
The score is now tied at one.
Here we go. Things are getting interesting.
And it looks like the runner is down at first base.
Who is that? Is that Borrello?
Yeah. Antonio Borrello is down at first base and is being assisted by coaches currently.
Well, hopefully he's okay. Doesn't look like it's... Looks like he's getting up. Well, let's just hope that he's okay. Definitely walking a little bit funny, but. Nonetheless, that hit really helped his team out and finally got Blackhawk on the board.
Pinch runner at first base, Lucas Walton, number 22. Comes in for Antonio Borrello. And now batting number 21, the shortstop, Ryan Jones.
Here's an interesting one. Other than just baseball, seems to enjoy pickleball. Plans to play for Allegheny in the foreseeable future.
Checks the runner and he throws that one high for a ball. Throws it back to first base and he dives in there safely. Fires at home, and that is called for strike number one. 1-1 is the count. Two outs. Score is tied now, 1-1 in the bottom of the fifth. And we play seven innings here in the American Legion baseball.
That's right.
So the Blackhawk team is looking to continue this two-out rally they have going on. Hits that one into left field. The left fielder runs in on that. Dips down and makes the snag. There are three outs now, and we are moving to the top of the sixth. The score remains 1-1 now after Blackhawk just scored, and there are five hits total in the game. We will be right back for the top of the sixth inning.
Stars at night are big and bright. Deep in the heart of Texas, the prairie sky is wide and high. Deep in the heart of Texas, the sage and blue is like perfume. Deep in the heart of Texas reminds me of the one I love.
deep in the heart of Texas. The coyotes wail along the trail, deep in the heart of
Aiden Zimmerman, number 27, the shortstop, leading off for Wilcox. Alex Tomczyk still on the mound for Blackhawk.
Any reason to change pitchers right now, though?
Curveball in there. Fouls that one off. 0-2 now, and there will now be a meeting on the mound. Little team motivation going on there by the infielders, talking the pitcher up, trying to help him get through this inning. Oh and two on the hitter. Fouls that one off to stay alive. Misses there low with the off-speed pitch. 1-2 now the count. And no outs here in the top of the sixth inning. Misses there inside. Count is now at 2-2. That one is hit towards the second baseman. Second baseman charging in. Throws it, and he is safe. He beats the throw. And Wilcox gets their first runner on of the inning.
Definitely excited to get to first there.
Now batting the number 3 hitter, number 11, Cameron Marciniak. Marciniak is a fan of the New York Yankees. His favorite player is Aaron Judge. Other than baseball, he played football, and his favorite food is steak. He also enjoys snowboarding, fishing, lifting, and playing his guitar.
Also wants to go to Gannon as well.
And his game day ritual is he wears the same pants every game. Fires, and that one is fouled into the backstop. Out of play. Count is 1-2 now on the batter. Checks the runner at first and throws not in time. Say he has a pretty great pickoff move. He's already picked off two people earlier today. Off-speed pitch, fouls that one. Out of play. Really making the pitchers work in this one.
So far been the story of the day.
Only six hits so far in total in the game, three by each team. And that one is fouled away too. There's been more foul balls in this game, I think, than any other game we've watched all tournament.
Yeah, I'll say so.
Just quality at-bats by both teams throughout this game. And a lot of strikeouts thrown by each pitcher. But checks him again at first. And he is safe. That one is hit. Bounces to the pitcher. Pitcher throws it to the shortstop. Tags second base. That runner is out at second. He gets tripped up by the runner that slid into second, so he could not make the throw over to first. But there's one away.
You know he's not happy about that either.
In the top of the sixth. Now the cleanup hitter, number 12, Caden Dennis, comes up to bat. Caden Dennis's ritual before the game is he likes to make himself a peanut butter sandwich and eat that.
Hey, you can't go wrong with a peanut butter sandwich.
I've never tried that before. Maybe a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
I usually do prefer jelly on my sandwiches.
A peanut butter sandwich. That's cool, though.
Yeah, why not? Gotta give him some props.
Really concerned about that runner on first base there.
Really got his eye on first.
Pitcher Alex Tomczyk keeps checking him over there.
You know, he's been doing that throughout this entire game. I mean, sometimes.
0-2 now on the batter, Caden Dennis. Getting a little bit of a lead over there on first base, and he throws the off-speed pitch, fields it, turns, throws it to first, and they get out number two as the runner advances from first to second base now. And now the five hitter, number one, Luke Zimmerman, is up to bat.
Lots at stake here for both teams. This is a must win.
Again,
the loser will not be moving on. They will be eliminated.
This is the final loser's bracket game for today. And the two games after this will be winner's bracket games.
Paxton and Phillipsburg.
We will live stream the 4:05 game after this between Phillipsburg and Paxton, but the 7:05 game tonight will not be live streamed. But if you are from Boyertown, you can watch it on the local television station. count is 2-1 on the batter. They are two away as there is a runner in scoring position on second. There's a curveball that is hit at the first baseman. The first baseman fields it, steps on first base to get out of the top of the sixth, and we will be back for more in the bottom of the sixth as Blackhawk will look to add more runs.
Great game so far.
Where it began, I can't begin to knowing, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Hand, touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you.
Now batting for Blackhawk, number 9, Anthony Malagis. Count is 0-1 on the batter. Swing and a miss there. Ahead on the batter, 0-2 now. That one misses in the dirt there for a ball.
Gotta wonder here if we'll even see a change at the mound. Doesn't look like that's the case as of right this second. Nor should it be. Both pitchers, again, phenomenal performances on both sides.
Misses low there for ball two. Count is now 2-2. Hits that one in between the second and first baseman to the right fielder for another hit for Blackhawk. Their fourth hit of the game.
Bats are starting to get going for Blackhawk here.
And time has been called as Jared Malagis will go out to talk to the third base coach. Shows the bunt, and that one is fouled back. Checks the runner at first. First runner on first has a decent lead over there. Dives back safely.
Switch between those wherever the ball is at.
shows the bunt, and he bunts that. That's up into the air. Third baseman's charging in on that, gets it, throws it to the first baseman, makes the play at first, but the runner will advance to second. So there is now one down, a runner on second, as number five, Josh Reed, the first baseman, comes to the plate.
The stakes number five, Josh Reed.
Josh Reed is a fan of the Pittsburgh Pirates. His favorite baseball player is O'Neal Cruz.
Looks like he listens to the same song before each game as well. I wonder which song he's referring to.
He enjoys fishing, hunting, and playing cornhole.
Cannot go wrong with cornhole.
Count is now 1-1. That last pitch was low for a ball. Game is still tied 1-1 in the bottom of the sixth. That one is high for a ball. Count is now 2-1 on the hitter. Little bit outside for ball three. Count is now 3-1. Josh Reed coming into the season had 59 at-bats, 29 hits, and 21 RBIs. And he is walked there as that one is thrown behind him. Now there are runners on first and second base. Number 11, Louis Sebastian, the left fielder, now comes up to bat. Hits that one up the middle. Shortstop makes the catch, steps on second, and gets the double play. That was picture perfect right there.
What a play by Aiden Zimmerman.
Right to the left of him. Momentum coming forward on the bag to make out number three. And Wilcox will be up the top of the sixth. We will be right back for the top of the seventh. We will be right back.
Phenomenal stuff.
For that.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country roads, all my memories gather round her, miner's lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eye. Country roads, take me home to the place.
We are back for the top of the seventh. Wilcox is up to bat. Number 24, Ethan Wells, the sixth hitter and catcher, now batting. and it's in there for a call, strike two. Ethan Wells plans to, and his favorite non-baseball team is Duke basketball. Along with that, his favorite food is chicken wings, and his favorite baseball player is Yadier Molina. Oh, and the umpire is down currently and looks like in pain. So they are checking on him right now.
Oh no. Well, hopefully the umpire's okay. I didn't see what happened there. But it seems like they're calling for a medic.
Yeah, he got hit by the baseball.
Oh boy. You never want to see this stuff in any sport, for that matter. Especially when it's to an umpire. It's a good sign to see him sitting up, though.
Looks like he seems to be okay.
That
he is
good. That is good.
Talking and now he is getting up.
Roger.
And he seems to be okay.
A quick drink of water, should be okay. They're gonna bring out a stretcher, but it's a good thing that he's standing up.
Yeah, I don't think they're gonna need the stretcher.
I don't think they will either.
But anyways, the count is 3-2 on the batter here in the top of the seventh. The game is tied 1-1. Whoever wins will move on and play at 12:40 tomorrow. Whoever loses will be eliminated. So far, Greater Pittston was eliminated earlier today by Norchester. Norchester out of Region 2 beat Greater Pittston out of Region 5, 6-2. And Norchester will play at 3:40 tomorrow, and they will face the loser of Game 8 between Falls and Boyertown, which will be played tonight at 7:05.
Boyertown residents, you can catch that game on television then. On your local station.
And home plate umpire is okay. And
looks like he's going to keep.
We are ready to
keep at it.
Continue.
Nice.
And play ball. That one is hit high up into the air. The pitcher is getting under that. He calls it, and he makes the play. I know the sun had to be a pain for him there to make that, but
I don't think that he's helping either.
He was able to make the catch, and there is one away in the top of the seventh. And it looks like there will be a pitching substitution as pitcher Alex Tomczyk will be subbed out of the game.
Great outing for Tomczyk.
Looks like number 44, Clay. Oh, never mind.
Oh, he's still in there, huh?
I thought he was coming out to take the mound. I guess so. Number 9, Anthony Malagese, will actually be taking the mound.
Give him some time to warm up. Crucial situation he's getting thrown into.
Got a little brother-on-brother action here. The pitcher,
that's right.
Pitcher Anthony Malagese and the
Jared.
Catcher Jared Malagese.
It's always cool to see brothers playing on the same team, especially when one's a pitcher and the other's a catcher.
Due up for Wilcox is the bottom of the lineup, the 7-8-9 hitters. Number 6, Colin Porter, followed by 22, Dalton Staley, who's on deck. And in the hole, number 28, Caden Smiley. And then it will flip to the top of the order. And he swings at that one for strike number 1. That one is hit into right field. The right fielder moves to his left, makes the catch for out number 2 in the top of the 7th. As this one remains tied 1-1 in this very defensive showdown going on. That one is outside for ball 1. Throws that one in there for a strike. Count is 1-1 on the batter. Misses there, just high. Hits that one towards the second baseman. Second baseman moves back, collects himself, and makes a throw as the Blackhawk gets out of the top of the 7th, and we are going to the bottom of the 7th. If they can score in the bottom of the 7th, the game will be over and Wilcox will be eliminated. If not, we will be going to extra innings.
Well, if they don't collapse, like they did yesterday.
Thank you.
Now batting the seven hitter, Zane Priestus Kish for Blackhawk. Throws that one past him.
You know, it's going to be very, very important for Wilcox to hang on here. As you know, yesterday in this inning, in the seventh, they really collapsed against Boyertown, which resulted in a 7-0 loss.
That one is outside. Count is now 1-1. We are in the bottom of the seventh. That one is hit out of play.
Foul ball.
Count moves to 1-2. Off-speed pitch, that one is fouled off down the first baseline. Wilcox looking to get these three outs and send this to extras. Blows that past him for strike three. It's another strikeout for number six, Colin Porter. He's really been working it on the mound today.
He's got to be one of the best pitching performances that I've seen all tournament long.
Second baseman number 23, Owen Keister.
Owen Keister, number 23, now batting. The eight hitter in the lineup. That one is thrown outside for a ball. That one is fouled back, out of play.
Oh, that hit the stands.
Yeah, it hit the stands over there.
Don't take out our cameras.
Nope, our cameras are fine.
That is good.
Another one fouled back. There's definitely been more foul balls in this one than any other game we've witnessed yet. Another one fouled off.
Oh my gosh.
Really high quality at bats from both teams in this one.
Well, as they've been performing, the pitcher.
Keister, hang. Count is now 2-2.
No, I haven't seen this
here. Here I keep seeing the stop and the start. I mean, it just drags a little bit.
And that one is called strike three. And now they are two away in the bottom of the seventh. Number 15, Alex Tomczyk, who was the former pitcher coming up to bat. And it looks like they are going to have a sub pitcher come in now.
That's interesting.
To finish this game off, 00 Dom Allegretto will come in to pitch. Great performance by pitcher Colin Porter today.
Definitely.
And
to be ashamed of.
Also great performance by pitcher for Blackhawk, Alex Tomczyk. But now they both subbed in new pitchers for this last inning. Wilcox can get one more out without allowing a run here, this game will go to extra innings and be the first extra inning game of the tournament.
Perfect game for extra innings, huh?
Yeah.
I'll say.
I mean, great weather for it.
Very great weather. Beautiful weather.
Ladies and gentlemen, now pitching for Wilcox. Double zero, Dom Algetta.
All right. His first pitch is coming up.
Center fielder number 15, Alex Tomczyk.
That one is thrown low for ball one. That one is catch, and it looks like we are going to extras.
Let's go. Let's get it.
The top of the eighth coming up. We will be right back. Tune in for more. Now batting the number 9 hitter, number 28, Caden Smiley. He hits that one towards the second baseman. The second baseman runs in on it. Makes a wild throw, and he is now advancing to second. And that is Blackhawks' first error of the game.
Man, it took the extra innings for it to happen. And you know what? This game could go anybody's way. This is anybody's game at this point.
Now coming up the bat, the number 1 hitter, the pitcher, Dom Allegretto. And now Wilcox is in their top of their lineup where all their...
You know, Walker, I think I would have to say that this is probably one of the
shows the
games.
Bunt and pulls back. Yes, I'd say this one and Paxton Norchester have been the closest this far. And it shows the bunt, and that one is fouled right over the third base dugout. Trying to advance the runner to score him here. Shows the bunt again, and that's a wild throw.
Oh boy.
Into the backstop as the runner will advance to third. So number 28, Caden Smiley, is on third base, and he is in scoring position. And Wilcox has three chances to score now. There is nobody out here in the top of the eighth.
Sure looking good for him.
Despite the roster of only 14 kids on Wilcox, they have been doing pretty well with those 14 players on their team. He hits that one down the third baseline, and it's fielded foul just left of the line. Count is now full at 3-2. No outs. A sack fly is all they need here just to get him in, to get up one. But still, Blackhawk will get the chance to bat because they are the home team. That one is thrown outside for ball four, and now there are runners on first and third with no outs as number 27, Aiden Zimmerman, comes up to bat.
Very productive day for Aiden Zimmerman.
He took sixth place at this year's state tournament in AA wrestling.
Runner goes for second, and the catcher doesn't even worry about throwing it down there because he's more worried about the runner on third, because if he scores, they are up one, and Blackhawk will have to score in the bottom of the inning, or else they will lose this one and be eliminated from the tournament. Only one team has been eliminated so far. Greater Pittston earlier today lost 6-2 against Norchester. And that one is drilled down the third baseline. And the third baseman was playing up, so that one got past him, and two runners are coming into home to score. Throw is not in time, and the runner is headed for third now. A stand-up triple.
Now they are cooking. They are cooking.
Wilcox now leads 3-1 against Blackhawk.
Blackout manager is not happy. There's something going on in the field.
It seems like he said double zero.
Yeah,
screamed.
That'd be Allegretto that he's talking about. Of course, these players are young, of course. Of course, they're going to let their emotions get the best of them, but that's baseball.
Cam Marciniak, the three hitter. That ball is thrown outside for a ball. Wilcox leading 3-1 here in extras in the top of the eighth. That one is fouled back. Count now moves to 1-1. There's a runner on third base.
Future Gannon attendee looking to bring him back home.
There's an off-speed pitch. Fouled off for strike two. So the umpire will walk. Marciniak looking to add insurance runs to Wilcox lead right now, as there are still no outs, and there is a wild pitch thrown, but the catcher gets back and grabs it quickly, and the runner decided to stay at third. So score remains 3-1. and there are no outs. The count is 2-2. Makes the tag on the player for out number one. Now the cleanup hitter, number 12, Caden Dennis, coming up to bat.
Crazy, after all of that, that's our first out for the new inning.
And he crushes that one into left field, lines that down, and Wilcox adds another run, an RBI for Caden Dennis. Score is now 4-1 as Luke Zimmerman comes up to bat. That one is called a ball inside. Yesterday, Wilcox faced Boyertown and lost 7-0, and Blackhawk faced Falls and lost 11.
Malagese is struggling.
That one is inside for a ball. Count is now 3-0. On the up will be, he shows the bunt. Next up will be Paxton versus Phillipsburg, which will be a winner's bracket game. Paxton defeated Norchester yesterday 4-3, and Phillipsburg beat Greater Pittston 7-1.
See players from
that ball is fouled down the first baseline.
Starting to show up now.
Phillipsburg and Paxton approximate start time will be around 4:05, which we will be live streaming, so tune in for that. And another walk there to add another runner on base for Wilcox. Wilcox now has a runner on first, comes up to bat. And there looks like there will be a meeting on the mound as the coach and team are walking out to meet with pitcher. Anthony Malagese.
Gotta say, if you're Blackhawk here, I'm sure you're hoping for a quick double play. Just get out of here.
Oh my God, Bruce.
Now batting. Ethan Wells. That ball gets past the catcher. Catcher, they are on second and third now. The count is 1-1.
So much for that double play. I have to get a strikeout or something. Blackhawk needs to do something. And desperately.
And the infield seems to be moving up to make the play at the plate, so no more runners can score as Wilcox leads 4-1. They have scored 3 in the top of the 8th inning. And that one is high for ball 4. Bases are now loaded.
And here comes Porter. Colin Porter. My mistake.
Now batting number 6, Colin Porter, who was previously pitching for Wilcox. That one gets thrown past him there. Little heater on right there. Count is 0-1. There's the off-speed pitch, misses there. Count is now Cork. Throws another one past him. 1-2. And Blackhawk just looking to get out of this one without allowing any more insurance runs from Wilcox.
They need to do it quick. Need to regroup.
Really going to have to get the bats going in the bottom of the eighth.
Try to get their mojo back.
Get some swing in there for strike three. And that is two outs, and that is what Blackhawk needed right there. The nice curveball thrown by Anthony Malagese. That one is thrown high for a ball. Seems like Anthony Malagese has been struggling a little bit to find a strike zone. Keeps throwing a lot of...
That's one.
Now leads 5-1, and that is a stand-up double.
Tell you what, that hole is just getting deeper and deeper now for Blackhawk.
Runners are now on second and third. Or 6-1. So they've scored 5 runs in this eighth inning now. Score is 6-1. Number 28, Caden Smiley up the bat now. He was the first run for Wilcox earlier in this game.
But I say, I really think the momentum switched when Blackhawk made a change.
Yeah, when they switched pitchers, yeah.
Definitely really affected the rest of this game.
And that one's hit at the shortstop. Shortstop's running in. He boots that ball, and Wilcox scores again.
Oh, boy.
That is going to be an error on the shortstop as Wilcox adds two more right there and extends the lead. Made 3 errors in this one and seems to be just absolutely falling apart defensively. It's almost like they've given up, already being 0-1 in the tournament, and they lose this, they are eliminated and will be a second team eliminated. Greater Pittston earlier was eliminated.
They're going to need 7 runs at least.
Blackhawk is out of Region 6, and Wilcox is out of Region 8.
Hey, we've seen miracles before. I'm not going to count them out, but they really, really, really need to regroup. Really talk to each other.
That one is in there for a called strike 2. Count is even at 2. And there are 2 outs here in the top of the 8th inning. That one is hit right back at the pitcher. The pitcher walks over and flips it to first to make the easy play. That is it for the top of the 8th. In the bottom of the 8th, Blackhawk will need to score at least 7 runs to extend this game, or 8 to win it. They're going to really need to get the bats going. They want to come back in this one. We will be right back for the bottom of the 8th inning. For the bottom of the 8th inning, the score is 8-1, Wilcox.
Hey Walker, what was that song we were playing? Don't bring me. go.
Another one in there. Swings and misses. 0-2 the count.
Alright, let's see what happens here.
Blackhawk down to their final three outs. Get some swinging for out number. Wilcox needs two more to get out of this one and advance to tomorrow's game, which they will be playing at 12:40 if they can win this one. Now batting number 20. That one is in there for a strike. There's all spots. That one is low. Good block by the catcher there. Number 24, Ethan Wells, with the block. That one is thrown high for a ball. Count is now even at 2. And that one is thrown low for a ball. Count is now 3-2. The crazy thing is this Wilcox team, Boyertown, pretty much did what throws the first for out number 2. So what I was saying was Wilcox is doing what happened to them yesterday against Boyertown,
yeah,
to Blackhawk.
Fell behind
is what I was going
to say. And
yes.
Now they're on the opposite side this time around. Sure, it's a good deal.
And Blackhawk is now down to their final out.
Great game to call.
Yeah,
great game to watch.
Great game throughout. Made it to extras and pitching changed everything. And he hits that batter as number 9, Anthony Malagese, the pitcher, will move on to first base.
I think that's the first time a player's been hit by a ball, right? Pretty sure.
No, there was...
Or today, I mean. Not throughout the tournament.
No, there was one earlier.
Oh.
Yeah, there was...
You're right.
Someone got,
you're right. You're
someone
right.
got
yeah,
hit earlier, yeah. That one is thrown high and gets past the catcher. The runner advances to second easily. Two outs in this one. Blackhawk is trying to start a rally here. They're going to need 7 runs. At least. That pitch is thrown high. Counting is 2-0 on the batter. Just throwing low for a ball. Dom Allegretto trying to find his composure here.
Well, this is good if you're a Blackhawk fan. Or parent. Or player.
That's in there for a strike. Count is now 3-1. The runner on second. Throws that one in there.
Down to their last strike.
Just hits down low there for strike number 2. Count is now 4. And there are 2 outs. That one is hit high. And the shortstop is getting under that.
Got him.
And he makes the catch. And Wilcox will advance as they defeat Blackhawk 8-1 in extras.
What a game.
A great game.